Alright, so in this video I'm going to be doing a review and a demonstration of the new lock, keyless Bluetooth bicycle lock, which is essentially a cable lock, which it can be used for locking up a variety of different things, but the main thing that I'll be using it for is for locking up bicycles. And what makes this lock unique from other locks is that it doesn't use a key. It's a keyless lock system that uses a Bluetooth signal to be able to unlock it. So rather than carrying a key around, you just have to have an app on your Bluetooth-enabled device, which you can use to send a signal to the lock every time that you want to unlock it. So we'll just start off by demonstrating how it works. So on the side here of the main body, there's this little button which you can press, which releases this part of the lock. And then you'll go and you'll lock up, you know, whatever it is you're needing to lock up. And then I would just click it back in place there like that. And after you hear it click, you know it's in there. So what we have to do to actually arm the lock is there's this little button here on the front. And of course, I've already set this thing up. I've already put batteries in and everything, so it's already ready to go. So for me, now that I'm ready to lock up my bike, all I've got to do is just press this button here on the front. And we'll hear it makes a sound. So three beeps indicates that it's been locked. Now if I press on this button on the side here, I can feel that it doesn't go in the same way that it did before, and I'm not able to pull this cable out. It's in there securely. So later in the video, I'll get into more details about the built-in security features that it has. But for now, I'm just going to show you how to unlock it. So as I mentioned before, you need a Bluetooth-enabled device, and you download an app. I'm just going to be using my iPad to demonstrate this because the screen is bigger, so it's easier to see. But I also have the same app installed on my Android phone. It's available for iOS or for Android. And the app you have to download is called SLB Lock. So I have it here, and I just open up and launch it. And you would pair it with the locks that you have. And the one that I have right here is called cjhoyle lock, and these are connected. So right now I just tap on that, and there's a bunch of different features there, but right now all I'm interested in is just unlocking this thing. So all I've got to do is just press this unlock button, and you hear that it beeped once, and it says on the screen unlock successful, okay. And then from here I'm just able to press on this button again, and I'm able to pull my lock out. So as you saw, locking and unlocking this lock is pretty straightforward. It works pretty much the way that you'd expect it to. But aside from the fact that it uses Bluetooth, what exactly does this lock have built into it that makes it unique from other locks? Well, one feature that it has that a traditional lock probably doesn't have is it does continuity checking. So what it does is it's checking this cable here. It's basically, it's able to send, you know, electronic signals through here to be able to see that this side here is connected up with this side here. So that means that if a bike thief comes along and they decide to snip through this cable with their cable cutters, then the lock here knows that, you know, that this is no longer making an electrical connection, and then it triggers an alarm, and it's actually quite a loud alarm that's built into this. Now, I don't want to actually destroy this lock just to demonstrate that to you, because I do plan on using this lock, but I did figure out a way that you can simulate what it would be like if someone cut through it by disconnecting the continuity. And before I do that demonstration, I'm going to put on my hearing protection, because when this alarm goes off, it is very loud, and I would say it's painfully loud, and it probably could do some damage to your hearing. But what I figured out is that you can trick it by making it think that it's latched, but not actually latching it. So basically, if I push this part of the way in like that before this thing clicks, so I'll just unclick that and put it in something like that, then I could press the button here and it would think that it was locked, and then I could pull it out, and then it simulates what it would be like if the cable had been cut. So we'll just push that so it's almost all the way in. Then I'll press my button here, and the three beeps indicates that it's been locked. And if you look at the light there, you should see that it's blinking every few seconds or so. And now I'm going to pull this thing out, and we will hear a very loud alarm. So unfortunately, because of the way that my camera balances audio, you can't really get a good sense of how loud this thing actually is. According to the manual, it's 110 decibels. I have no way of actually verifying that. Take my word for it, it is extremely loud, and it does actually, as I said, hurt my ears when it goes off. So I guess the idea behind that feature is that when a bike thief cuts through the lock and the alarm triggers, it'll first of all startle them, but second of all, it'll draw attention to them, which, you know, if you're committing a crime, you wouldn't want, you know, people looking at you and having, you know, all this attention drawn to you. So hopefully it would deter the thief and make them change their mind about stealing the bike. I could also see it being really helpful if you had locked your bike up outside of your home, because, you know, you're sitting inside your house and you hear, you know, your bike lock alarm going off. It will alert you to it, and you would hopefully be able to go outside in time to be able to intervene, to be able to prevent your bike from getting stolen. But now you're probably wondering, what if the bike thief is smart enough to realize that this lock has an alarm built into it, and that they could probably just take the batteries out before they cut through the lock so that it's not going to go off? Well, the manufacturer of this lock thought of that as well, and there's actually an alarm built in too if you try and take the screws out from the battery pack. So I'll just demonstrate that for you as well. Now, of course, this alarm is only going to trigger if the lock is actually in the locked position, because they need to give you some way of actually changing your battery. So, of course, you can do that anytime when your lock has been unlocked. But I also believe that this alarm won't trigger if your device, which you have linked up with it, is within range of it. So basically, I guess the idea behind that is that it figures that, you know, if your phone is close enough to the device, when you're changing the batteries, then it figures that it's probably you that's changing the batteries, so it's not going to trigger the alarm in that situation. So to simulate this, I've turned the Bluetooth off on the iPad here. But we'll just give this a try and try taking out one of these screws, and we'll see what happens. That one came out no problem. Oh, there it goes. That was very loud. You can hear. Can't really hear my voice over it very well. All right, so now you're probably saying, well, it's great that this lock has an alarm built into it, but if it's getting triggered by somebody cutting through it or removing the battery pack, then that might already be too late. You know, someone may have already been able to make off with it in the time that it took for them to just cut it and throw the lock away and then run away. Well, the lock does have one other feature built into it, which is a vibration alarm in it. So that's something that's optional, you have to turn on. But if I come into my app here, and you can look at this list here, you see that one of the options here is vibration. So if I activate that, now it will detect vibration and it will trigger the alarm based on vibration. So I'll put my hearing protection back on to protect my ears. So I've got the vibration activated on the app. If I pick up the lock and I start moving it around, you'll hear that actually nothing's happening. And that's what I mentioned earlier, the alarm in here is disabled when your device is within range of it. So basically, if you've locked up your bike and then you need to go back to your bike and, you know, move something around or do something to your bike, it's not going to go off for you, but after you walk away and your device is far away from it, then the vibration part will be active. So to actually simulate that, I'm just going to turn off the Bluetooth on this device here. So now it's disconnected. So now if a bike thief comes along and they decide to start tampering with this, you hear that as I turned it over, it made a little bit of a noise. It was a very small vibration just from flipping it over. That was enough to trigger the preliminary alarm, which is basically just to let the bike thief know that, hey, this is a motion-activated alarm. You shouldn't mess with it. And from what I understand, that initial warning alarm, that happens every 5 seconds or so. So you're able to touch it for 5 seconds. But then if you just let go of it, it's not going to send the main alarm, which is, I think, kind of a good feature, because, you know, basically we don't want this alarm going off all the time and annoying everybody around it. But if someone comes along and they touch it and it makes a noise and then they keep moving it around and they keep, you know, trying to tamper with it, then that alarm will go off and let them know that, hey, this is something you shouldn't mess with. All right, so now I'll just show a couple of the remaining features which I haven't covered yet. When you're inside the app, it will tell you the amount of power that's left in the batteries that are built into your lock. It takes 3 AAA batteries. My batteries are practically brand new, so it's showing almost 100%. I have noticed this number jumps around a little bit, so it's not completely exact, but it's close enough, and the idea is just to keep an eye on that so you remember to change your battery so you're not going to be leaving it locked up somewhere and the battery to die and then you don't have an alarm active anymore and you're not actually able to unlock it. There's also a neat feature here which is called the auto lock. So I showed you vibration. The auto lock, the way that works is when you enable that, it's like a proximity sensor. It's the way that some cars work now, where the doors will unlock when you get close to it, when you have your key fob in your pocket. This works the same way. It will unlock the lock when you get closer to it, So it'll be ready for you. So all you'll have to do is just press on this button on the side to be able to unlock it. Of course, that's an optional feature as well. So some people might love that feature depending on your security situation where you're using this. You might think that's a terrible feature because you don't want it to be unlocked unless you physically, you know, unlock it. You don't want it to be unlocked before you're actually standing right next to your bike. Down here, there's also a change password button, which I'd recommend using after you first set up your lock. The way that this works is when you first pairing your device with your lock, you have to type in a password. And in the manual, I believe it says the initial password is set as 123456. You type that in and it will allow you to pair it with that. Now, of course, someone else with the app, if they just type in 123456, then they would be able to pair their device to your lock and they'd be able to unlock it instead of you. So, of course, I would recommend changing your password to something that's not the default one so that only you will know that password. And then finally, there's a button down here which allows you to change the name of your lock. You can see that I have named mine CJ Hoyle Lock. And I guess the idea of naming your lock is just because if you have more than one of these, then it allows you to be able to, when you're looking on the screen, you'll see your multiple locks on here, so you'll know to be unlocking the one that you actually want to be unlocking at that time. So this is the box that the lock comes in. It comes with an owner's manual, as well as a little small carrying case for putting the lock into, as well as this other pamphlet which shows some of the other products that this Nuvending company sells. The lock uses 3 AAA batteries, and batteries are not included. As you can see, this battery compartment has a rubber seal around it, and that's because this lock is water resistant, meaning that it's possible for this thing to get a little bit wet. You can certainly take it out in the rain and get splashed and things like that. You probably wouldn't want to submerge this into deep water, but for a bike lock, you wouldn't really need to do that anyways. So now that I've demonstrated how it works, I'm now going to give you my opinion on the lock. But first I want to refer back to a video that I made in the past, which is called Complete Guide to Bike Locks. One of the important things that I pointed out in that video was that the type of bike lock that a person should use really depends on the sort of situations that they're using for locking up their bikes. And it kind of boils down to 3 main factors. Factor A would be how valuable is the bike that you're locking up. Item 2 is where exactly are you going to be locking up your bike. And the third factor is how long are you going to be leaving your bike, or how long is your bike going to be sitting in that locked up area for when you're leaving it unattended. So my opinions on this lock are going to be based on the sort of situations where I would see myself using a bike lock. And that is to say, even though I don't ride bikes which are extremely expensive, I do live in a city where bike theft is fairly common, and I actually did have a bike stolen last year. So relatively speaking, I think I am in the category of someone that is looking for bike locks which are fairly high-end with a high level of security. All right, so I'm gonna start off with the things that I don't like about this lock, and I'll finish off with the things that I do like about it. So to start off, although I think this is a neat concept and a neat idea for a lock, I personally don't think that this lock for me, for my situation, is going to be replacing the other locks that I currently use. Unfortunately, I just don't think that it's secure enough. The cable that they used is very thin, so it really wouldn't take very much to cut through. I don't even think you'd need a full-size set of bolt cutters. You might even be able to do it just with a regular pair of side cutters. Combined with the fact that the body of the lock, this part here, is actually made out of a hard plastic material. So I think if someone wanted to get in there, they could pretty easily just smash it with a hammer. But of course, the concept of this lock is that the materials that it's made out of are not really that important, because it's the alarm that's supposed to be the part that is scaring away the thief, or it's deterring the theft of the bike. But I don't personally feel that an alarm is going to be as effective as a higher grade security material that the lock can be made out of itself. So my fear is that a bike thief comes along and they see how thin this is and they clip through it, of course, which triggers the alarm, which then of course makes them run away. But eventually the bike is just sitting there unlocked, and anyone, including the original thief, could just come over to it and take the bike. Initially, I thought that the saving grace for this lock might be that it has that vibration alarm built into it. And the idea would be that you could turn that on and the alarm would go off when a bike thief, just before they even tried to cut the lock or tried to remove the batteries, it would already start to go off, which would just hopefully just, you know, scare the thief away and make them, you know, go and move on to another bike. However, the potential problem that I see with the vibration alarm is that in a lot of situations, when I'm locking up my bike, I'm locking it up in locations where there's lots of other bikes locked up, like in a bike rack or something. And sometimes the bikes tend to be pretty cramped and pretty close together and even touching each other sometimes. So my fear is that if I have the vibration alarm activated on this lock, that someone else will be coming to unlock their bike and they'll bump into my bike a little bit, not too much, but enough to activate the alarm. And then of course your alarm is getting triggered. And I'm concerned that for me, the vibration alarm would get triggered quite frequently from my lock. So my concern with that is that if the lock is frequently getting triggered, that it's probably gonna be annoying a whole lot of people who are close to it. And my concern is that, let's say that I've locked my bike up outside of somebody's home or outside of somebody's business, and unbeknownst to me, after I've locked it up and walked away and did my own thing, the alarm just keeps getting triggered from other people, you know, doing stuff in that area, then the people in that house or inside that business are probably gonna be getting pretty annoyed when every hour or so this alarm is making a whole lot of noise and disturbing them. So I could see the potential for them coming outside and deciding to, you know, take the matter into their own hands. And as I said before, they could probably just smash this with a hammer and disable it somehow. Or they might even just, you know, take the batteries out and disable my lock. Another minor criticism that I have for the lock is that although the alarm, the sound that comes out of it is exceptionally loud and it does hurt my ears, I've noticed that if I cover the lock with my hand and I cover, you know, the area where it comes out with my fist like this, it muffles it considerably and it makes it almost, I wouldn't say silent, but it makes it a very quiet noise that most people, you know, wouldn't really draw too much attention to. So I do see the potential of a thief, you know, going off and then just grabbing it and just simply doing that, realizing that it's much quieter. And I guess it gives them more of an opportunity to be able to cover it up and be able to remove the screws and take the batteries out. Another minor negative point about this lock is that according to the manual, it only works down to negative 10 Celsius. For a lot of people, that probably wouldn't be a big deal because they don't live in a very cold climate, or they don't ride their bike, at least when it's cold outside. But for me, I like to ride my bikes 12 months of the year, so this lock wouldn't be usable for me for every day of the year, unfortunately. That being said, though, that's just according to what the manual says. It says negative 10. I haven't actually been able to test that yet, so it may work much colder than negative 10 Celsius. It probably actually has a lot to do with the type of batteries that you use in the lock. All right, so now to talk about all the things that I like about this lock. The number one thing I'd say is that I like that it's lightweight and portable. Usually higher security bike locks tend to have, you know, really thick, heavy materials, and, you know, carrying one of those around with you when you're gonna go somewhere to lock it up, that can really weigh you down because those locks can be very heavy. So I really like that this one is lightweight. It really doesn't weigh very much at all, and it's fairly portable as well. I'm just comparing it to this cable lock, this combination cable lock that I've had for many years. This one is actually quite a bit heavier than this thing. The reason, of course, is this one has more cabling to it, but I actually think that the amount of cable that this lock here comes with is probably adequate for most situations with the bike. Although I said earlier in the video that I don't see this lock replacing the ones that I'm currently using for locking up my bikes, that doesn't mean that I don't have a useful purpose for this lock. One of the techniques that I talked about in my complete guide to bike locks video is the idea of using two locks to lock up your bike instead of one. The idea behind that is that theoretically it would take a thief twice as long to be able to get through both of your locks than it would to just steal another bike which had only one lock on it. The trade-off to that technique, however, is that if you're using two locks to lock up your bike, it's probably going to take you about twice as long each time that you want to lock up your bike. So it definitely adds inconvenience to it. So the situation where I see myself using this bike lock the most would be using it as my secondary lock. And the advantage this lock offers over other locks that I might decide to use as my secondary lock is that it's very quick and easy to lock and unlock. Particularly if I decide to use the auto unlock feature where all I have to do is press the button to lock it, and then when I walk back to come and get my bike again, it senses the proximity of my Bluetooth signal, and by the time I get to my bike, the lock is already unlocked and ready for me to just take it off and then to spend the same amount of time I would normally spend on unlocking my other more secure lock. So another obvious advantage of this lock is that it's keyless, which means you don't have to carry a key around with you, which for some people that would be really handy. Of course, you have to carry your phone around with you, but most people do that all the time anyways. You do also have to worry about your phone running out of batteries, although I realize that if your phone runs out of batteries and you have a friend there that has a smartphone, they can probably just download that app for you, and as long as you still remember your password from their phone, you'd still be able to unlock your bike if you needed to in a pinch. Another positive aspect about this lock is that I think that it's reasonably priced. In Canada, to order one of these, it's only $50, including shipping, which for everything that comes inside here, you know, all of the electronics and everything, I think that's really reasonably priced. So anyway, that concludes this video review and demonstration of this lock. Special thanks to the company that makes these, Nuvending, for providing me with this lock for this review. If you're interested in purchasing one of these locks, they're available on Amazon, and there's a link below in the description of this video. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a comment below and let me know what you thought, and thanks for watching.